Do you feel the blues? I'm having new topic, but before that I want to thank you everyone that you're keeping track of my all videos. I hope you're enjoying all the videos. Today I'm going to show you how to do setting of rear brake, setting of rear brake pedal as well, because many of you has told me, and in fact a lot of complaints also came to my workshop, keep coming to my workshop with these kind of stuff. So I thought of sharing with you this information as well. It's a very short thing and a very small thing, but we can't neglect that. So what is the topic now? As I said, setting of the brake and the brake pedal, but this is all related to rear one. So as you can see right now, I kept the bike as it is because I worked on one of the video for the chain setting. So now I'm going to show you how to do this pedal setting as well. So I kept it open so you can see all the spare parts. Now what is the complaint right now? As you can hear right now, what is the problem? The issue is what? This pedal is touching bottom side of the header, number one. Number two, my client has got no complaint of this level. Some client don't understand there has to be particular, I mean there should be one level. Some bikes I have seen like this way. When you start pressing your brake, the ankle starts, you know, aching because you press more downside. So remember, this level has to be both the your footrest and the brake pedal level has to be same. Should not be down or up as well, otherwise your ankle will start aching around. Now this has got one small sound, so I'm going to just little bit lowering, I'm going to lower down this brake pedal so it will not heat up my header, but I'll not lose my level as well, this footrest and brake pedal level. So there, it is a very small change now I'm going to do. Sometimes what I have heard, tung 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 sound, that means your brake pedal is basically hitting the header, so you have to lower down that. How to do that? Before that, I'm just going to make this brake loose with the help of 13mm ring ratchet, requiring 6mm Allen key and so the 13mm open end spanner to make it proper. Now the level can be changed by either lowering this bolt downside or upside. There is a rubber bush or kind of a padding they have provided on this brake pedal. I'll show you, and where this sound is coming from, that also I'll show you. See, this is the 8mm M8 bolt, and this is the rubber pad to avoid the sound, and you can hear the sound. So this is basically right now hitting the header. In this bike the shield is getting it's hitting the the pedal is basically hitting the main heat shield, so that we can do, but the gap is too much because I want to check the level also. So I'm going to lower down the brake pedal level, I'm going to make it according to the footrest. So for that, now we'll be using 13mm and the M6 or 6mm Allen key. So we'll be using 6mm Allen key and the 13mm open end spanner. Here first you have to make this nut loose, the 13mm nut loose, make it loose, and then start changing the level of the pedal. As you can see, it's going down now. A bit cozy, but you can do it. You can do it with great patience. Now there is no sound. I just changed the level. Now you can see this footrest and the brake pedal is also in level, and this one is not hitting the header from the bottom side. Now just make it confirm, I mean just make that nut tight, this 13mm nut tight, so this will not get loose while riding the bike because of the vibrations. So now this brake pedal is also in line, it's not hitting my shield as well as the header. Now we have to set the brake. Now how to set, how much you should set the brake? Remember, for that you will be requiring 13mm ring ratchet. I am using foldable. You can use regular socket also, 13mm deep socket, or you can use this open end spanner as well as you can use this ring spanner if everything is accessible, or else this is the best tool what I prefer generally. So I am going to make this brake tight. Don't make it too much tight, otherwise it will have no preloading. Now as you can see, it is just going almost 1.5 inch or 1 inch almost down. So this much brake slackness should be there, so you will have proper braking, not urgent braking I am saying, but urgent means what, you have to press the brake pedal very hard at a time of emergency. So this is how you have to set the brake pedal level and the rear brake setting. Thanks for watching and stay connected.